Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We meet once again in yet another exclusive encounter inside the Word of God. But before I take you into this sermon presentation, I just want to give you a reminder of what we covered last time. Last time, we covered a very essential sermon presentation, which was titled Knowledge and Wisdom. And I took you into a depth of knowledge and wisdom concerning two biblical characters of men that were gifted, men that had a chance to encounter wisdom coming directly from God, and men that were given knowledge that was heavenly, and that was Job and Solomon. Now, today, I want to take you into a sermon presentation that is going to guide you inside your calling. And I mean not only the calling of the things of the Spirit of God, but any area which God has called you. You need guidance. You need a compass. And that compass can only come when you know what the Holy Spirit titled unto me as the vision and mission. And inside that vision and mission, you'll be given the inspiration and the influence. So, for us to understand more the vision and the mission, let us get into scriptures. In the book of Matthew chapter 10 verse 1, and when he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal all manner of sicknesses and all manner of diseases. The first stage is that Jesus calls his disciples and he gives them authority. He gives them empowerment. The first stage, when you are visualizing to do anything as a child of God, is that you need to be given a vision. And when you are given a vision, that vision needs to be escorted by a certain level of empowerment. There's nothing that you are going to start, there's nothing that you are going to pioneer without a certain level of empowerment that comes from the Holy Spirit directly. Many people are keeping ideas. Many people have plans. Many people have had ideologies that have been in motion for decades that are failing to materialize. What is lacking there is the empowerment. And Jesus, as he sends the 12 disciples, he gives them power. He knows that if there is no power, they are not going to achieve anything. They are just going to have an empty vision. A vision without power, a vision without a certain level of conviction that is enhanced by a certain level of empowerment, does not have direction. It does not bear any fruit. And Jesus gives them power to cast out demons and to heal all manner of sicknesses. Now, after they had been given that power, these 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not. Now that you have a vision, you have been given probably a capital. Now that you have a vision, and you have probably prayed and fasted, and probably you are in ministry work, you must now know which places to start your business. You must now know which souls to win. You must now know which area draws clients to your business. You must now know what type of a calling you have and what type of souls you must interact with. So I'm trying to give you two different partitions of one that is called in business and one that is called in ministry work. You could be one that has been given an ability, but your ability needs the right people. That ability that you have been given in business, it is a specific location. And if that location is not fulfilled by your presence, by you being present in that location, then it becomes difficult for your destiny to manifest. Why? Because your destiny can only manifest when you are in a location that is applicable, a location that is relevant and connected to the people that you're supposed to meet. When you're called into ministry work again, you are given all the specific tools that are required for your calling to function. You are given a mentor who is relevant to your calling. You can't be mentored by someone that does not know your type of calling. Some of you, you despise the one that found your calling, the one that revealed your calling, and you admire the one that never said a thing to you. You are visualizing a calling that is insignificant. And in that danger, you can be mentored by the wrong person who never revealed who you are. And you abandon the one that found your calling. The whole vision in such a process can get hijacked by the devil. Why? Because your vision no longer has a foundation. The disciples have been given empowerment. They've been empowered by Jesus. And after being empowered by Jesus, they are given power in the name of Jesus to go and drive out demons in that same name. There is a name that called you. And that name that called you is probably the same name that named you. Whatever named you has power to call you. Whatever named you has power to send you. And whatever called you is power to reveal your vision. Your vision is insignificant without a compass. And whatever mission that is installed inside your vision, it can only be relevant whilst you are subscribing to the requirements and the instructions that are relevant to the one that is called to mentor you. There is no one that can function in a calling without a mentor. There is no one that can function in a calling without being groomed spiritually. Yes, you need helpers for you to be groomed. But you only need one instructor. You only need one mentor that will guide you in your calling. Therefore, you have a vision, and that vision needs to be cultivated by a man that knows the land that you have been given and the yield that you're supposed to gather. You are supposed to work as a laborer in the kingdom of Christ. And you're expected to harvest souls. There will be someone that is going to be sent to you to guide you on how to plant your vision in the right fertile soil. That vision can only have significance when you are taking necessary instructions. The instructions that are necessary for your calling in that specific area that God has called you. There has to be relevance from the instructions that you are given by your mentor and the assignment that you have been given by the Holy Spirit. Some of you have started businesses a decade ago, 5 years ago, but your businesses, they don't seem to be moving. Why? Because your business can never function until your business subscribes to the instructions of the Holy Spirit. I've seen people that want to expand in business. People that have got access to open businesses in every part of the city. But when it comes to production, it becomes a different story. So that you understand that whatever mission you are given, that mission needs empowerment again in business. Your entrepreneurship skills, they are not enough. They need to be funded by the Holy Spirit. They need to be funded not only by money, but by wisdom and knowledge of knowing where to open a business, the prayers that are required for that business, and the mentorship that is required for that business. Some of your businesses, they don't even need too much of bookkeeping skills. No, they just need you to be a partner. They just need you to be focused in the things of God. Some of your businesses, they don't even need too much accounting. They need too much praying. Some of your businesses, they don't even need you to scratch your head and have sleepless nights wondering how you are going to capitalize and make profits. No. You just need to subscribe to spiritual instructions. And your mission in that business is going to be enhanced. Your mission in that business is going to make sense. There's going to be grace that you're going to be given by the Holy Spirit to run a business. Grace that you can never be given by a college or a university. Grace that you can never be given by a certain platform that you believe has got many clients or customers. Some of you, you are told that you are called, but your callings are not materializing in the things of God. You remain stuck in the same place. Why? Because you are not subscribing to mentorship. You believe that you can also hear the voice of God, which is fine. But why is it that the voice of God that you are hearing is not yielding the results that are required? If it is really God speaking to you, it's impossible for God to speak to each and every one of you. God is so principled. He operates in protocols. He operates in different orders of spiritual administration. not a God of confusion, but a God of order. So, I need you to understand something. You are given a mission in the same way the disciples were given an assignment and they were empowered. And they went out there and they started driving out demons under the empowerment of Jesus. You are given a mission in business and you are given empowerment on how to run that business. And how much that business is going to have influence and inspiration is going to be determined by the Holy Spirit. That mission you have in business, that mission you have in ministry, is going to be enhanced by your loyal level in the things of the Spirit. Your loyal level in the things of the Spirit is going to determine you to operate at a certain level of influence. A mission without the Holy Spirit is not fruitful. You need to be given the eyes of the Spirit even while you are in business. It's not only a calling inside the body of Christ that needs spiritual eyes. You also need to be given spiritual eyes while you are in business, to know where the money is supposed to come from, to know how losses have incurred, so that you correct the mistakes that you have been doing before. And most of you that have a vision and a mission in whatever God has gifted you, in the area that God has gifted you, you have not understood how your righteousness controls your vision and your mission, and how also your sinful life is capable to become a weapon of mismanagement. Let's take for instance that you are a fornicator and you are expecting profits in business. You can't be dining with the devil and then expect profits from the Lord. You can't be breaking bread with the devil in business and you expect a yield from God. So, once you are now operating in the things of God, once you have been called in the work of God, the one that has empowered you as a man or woman of God can only fulfill his promise if you are also loyal to the one that called you. And you can't serve two masters at the same time. You can't love women and also love the work of God. You can't love money and also love God. You can only have one God. Why? Because money has got the potential to become a God. Women have the potential to become a God or a goddess in your life. So there are possibilities that you can be worshipping that which is not, and you are expecting profit from the ultimate God that you are not worshipping. Child of God, you are being given the opportunity today by the Holy Spirit to shape your vision through the Holy Spirit, to shape your mission, to encourage yourself, to inspire yourself, to motivate yourself inside that calling through the Holy Spirit influence in the name of Jesus.